I've been doing this my business since 2009, and I've been mediocre at best, you know, throughout the years. Pretty good, but not really great or not really bad, just kind of in the middle. Struggled with my bills, struggled with this, struggled with that. And like I said, it's been about a year now, a little over a year that I went to the Bethlehem. I came here first and then went to the Bethlehem chapter. And since that time, with different conversations with different people, Art encouraging in a lot of different ways, but challenging me. One day we talked out here about the finances and how I was struggling and how, you know, I'm like, how can I, I'm giving God everything, I'm doing this. And I was praying for clients is what I was doing. And then it really dawned on me the one day that I need to stop praying for the clients. I need to start praying for people to witness to. So that was my goal and my challenge. So in the last year and a half, I probably had the opportunity to share my faith with probably 25 clients, prayed with probably at least 25 clients that were dealing with a lady who lost her husband, somebody whose son was an alcoholic and put into a hospital because of it. Just various different things where I was paying attention to what God was asking me to do. He put on my heart in November of last year to go to Haiti. So I went to our pastor and said, hey, I think we should go to Haiti next year. And pastor's like, well, can we go to some other place? So I was like, well, yeah, we could think about that, but we should go to Haiti. Didn't have any money to go to Haiti. My wife is like, you can't go. The week before, she's like, there's no way you should be going to Haiti. I'm like, honey, I don't know how it's going to happen. I just know God wants me to go to Haiti this year. He's going to work out the finances of everything that needs to be done. So in his infinite wisdom, she's like, well, the week before, you know, you lose money. The week of, you lose money. And the week after, you're not going to make any money. So we're going to have 3 weeks without any income. I said, I don't know how it's going to happen, but I have faith that God's going to work out all the details. The trip was totally paid for. Many people in the room helped pay for that trip. Above and beyond, so we were able to help the Haitian kids that were in the orphanage get more than what we had anticipated. But the week before, that week that I'm going to make $0, right, God blessed us with, I think the week before, it was a $3,000 commission check. The week while I was gone, while I wasn't working, but I was working for God's kingdom, he blessed us with a $2,000 check. The week that I got back, God blessed us with another $1,900 check. So in the 3 weeks that I wasn't supposed to make any money, God provided close to $10,000 to pay the bills, to do whatever, to get us caught up. It's been a struggle. It's been up and it's been down. And I have, you know, different things. But when I did the grand opening, plenty of people came. I opened an office in February of this year, did a grand opening. My agency manager from Ohio had asked, Randy, what's going on with your year this year? What's making you different? And I started to give him some answer like, well, I'm working a little bit different. I'm working a little smarter. And then it dawned on me that, you know what, I'm not really doing anything different, but I'm serving God and I'm putting God first. And I told this to the guy and he just looked at me like I had three heads, right? And then throughout the day, my pastor, Pastor Larry, comes in. He had gone to the church, or not to the church, but he had gone to the store for me to get some stuff to set up for the day. So he came. I introduced him to him, and we had conversation with the agency manager. He leaves, goes on. 10 minutes later, somebody else showed up, but I had 4, 5, 6 different people from BIB came on that day. And it wasn't that they just came to the office, but they came to the office and we prayed together. And he saw living God's principles in the office. And at some point on the one wall, I'll get something that's going to say honor and glory and praise, so that when anybody walks in, they're not going to see health markets, but they're going to see honor and glory and praise. So by me giving that, I was telling Art a little bit before the meeting. On August this past week, in the middle of August, I hit the income level that I made all of last year. So because I'm doing God's will and putting God first in everything, I'm finally getting it that when I'm all in, God's providing. So talk about changes in your business and allowing God to work. We are allowed to be missionaries in our own mission field in our daily walk. And if we're not, I'm challenging you that you want to do that, because there's nothing my God cannot do. And my God is alive today. So just thank you guys all again for the opportunity to share and be a part of this amazing group.